Good morning, friends. Myself, Ankit Patwari, back again. So today, as you can see in the screen, that we will be discussing going concern concept. This concept is very important when we do accounting, right? Let us go into the concept, that is going concern. Now, going concern concept says that business which we are doing will continue year after year in unforeseen future. Matlab aisa future jo dikhai nahi de raha hai, usme bhi business will continue. That means I assume perpetuity. If business is continuing year after year, it will go on for many years. So in order to measure performance, we have to divide the life of the business into small intervals, and that interval is of 12 months. Here is what accounting period concept is all about. So it is because of the going concern, we have to take accounting period assumption. Mera business sada bahar chalega. Year after year, the business will go on. So in order to measure the performance of the business, I have to divide the life of the business into small interval. That interval is of 12 months. This interval of 12 months is as per accounting period concept. So hum log jo bhi profit and loss and balance sheet banate, we make it for a time frame that is 12 months. Now going concern concept kya bolta hai? Going concern concept bolta hai that you need to make a distinction between capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. Now what is capital expenditure? Capital expenditure are those expenditures such as fixed asset which you incur and you derive benefit for more than one accounting year. And revenue expenditure are those expenditure that helps you in deriving revenue only for the current year. If the business is not going concern, then you need not have to distinguish between capex and revenue expenditure. There is no point distinguishing. But since our business is going concern, therefore we have to make a distinction between capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. Okay, fine. This much benefit has been derived, show it as an expense. This much benefit is yet to be derived and it's going concern. So you are going to derive in future, so you carry forward it. So agar hamare beech going concern concept nahi hota, to fixed asset and payment of salary dono ka treatment same hota. It is because of going concern concept, fixed asset and payment of salary are being treated as separate and distinct. Is then fine. Now another example of going concern concept would be the classification of fixed asset and current asset. Now again, current assets are those resources that will help you in deriving revenue in next 12 months. जैसे डेटर्स, उससे आपको पैसा मिल जाएगा आने वाला 12 महीने के अंदर अंदर. वेर एज फिक्स्ड एसेट इज दैट एसेट विच विल हेल्प यू इन डिराइविंग रेवेन्यू बियॉन्ड 12 मंथ्स. सो इफ देर इज नो गोइंग कंसर्न कॉन्सेप्ट, इन दैट केस यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू क्लासिफाई बिटवीन फिक्स्ड एसेट्स एंड करंट एसेट. द सेम इज द केस विथ लॉन्ग टर्म डेप्ट एंड करंट डेप्ट. So it is because of going concern concept, we have to make distinction between capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. It is because of going concern concept, we have to classify between fixed asset and current asset. It is because of this going concern concept, we have to classify between long-term debt and current debt. Now what if going concern concept is not followed? अगर मान लो मेरा गोइंग कंसर्न कॉन्सेप्ट इनअप्रोप्रिएट हो जाता ना, व्हाट डज द वर्ड इनअप्रोप्रिएट मींस? मतलब ड्यू टू सम रीजंस वी विल नॉट बी एबल टू कंटिन्यू आवर फ्यूचर our business in the future, then what will be the treatment? In that case, all expenses are to be shown in profit and loss account. There is no distinction between capex and revenue expenditure. You purchase fixed asset, show it in PL. You make payment for salary, show it in PL. Right? If going concern is inappropriate, there will not be any distinction between capex and revenue. Another, if going concern is inappropriate, in that case, all items of fixed asset will be shown at market value. If I'm going to liquidate my business, in that case, usually fixed asset ko hum log kis pe dikhate? Cost, less accumulated depreciation. And current asset ko kis pe dikhate? Cost or NRV. Jaise current asset mein hamara stock aata hai, debtor aata hai, cost or NRV, whichever is lower. So agar going concern inappropriate ho gaya, matlab hum hamara business future mein nahi kar payenge. In that case, I am going to report all assets at market value. That is net realizable value. ऐसा एक बिजनेस बताइए, आप लोगों ने बचपन में सुना होगा, जहां पे गोइंग कंसर्न कॉन्सेप्ट फॉलोड नहीं होता है, दैट इज जॉइंट वेंचर बिजनेस. तो जॉइंट वेंचर बिजनेस में आप लोगों को पता है हम लोग क्या ट्रीटमेंट करते थे? कोई क्लासिफिकेशन नहीं होता था फिक्स्ड एसेट एंड करंट एसेट के बीच में, कोई क्लासिफिकेशन नहीं होता था लॉन्ग टर्म डेप्ट एंड करंट डेप्ट के बीच में, कोई क्लासिफिकेशन नहीं होता था फिक्स्ड एसेट और पेमेंट ऑफ सैलरी के बीच में. तो सर मेरे को बताइए आप, अगर हमारा गोइंग कंसर्न मतलब बिजनेस विल कंटिन्यू इन अनफोरसीन फ्यूचर, इट मींस आई हैव टू मेक अ डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन कैपेक्स एंड रेवेन्यू, फिक्स्ड एसेट करंट एसेट, लॉन्ग टर्म डेप्ट एंड करंट डेप्ट. अगर गोइंग कंसर्न फॉलो हो रहा है ईयर आफ्टर ईयर, इन दैट केस फिक्स्ड एसेट को हम लोग दिखाएंगे कॉस्ट लेस डेप्रिसिएशन एंड रिमेनिंग कैरी फॉरवर्ड हो जाएगा, एंड करंट एसेट को वी विल शो एज पर cost or NRV, whichever is lower. Agar going concern inappropriate ho jata, matlab I'm going to liquidate my business in the near future. In that case, I will report all expenses in profit and loss account, no distinction between capital and revenue, and all items of assets and liabilities will be reported at market value. Is that clear, everyone? So thank you so much for staying tuned with us. Next class, we'll be back with some more interesting concepts. Namaste.